How many friends have you made today? Chapter 14, Part 2. Anan is being forced to face the elements as they all look at him. How did this happen? Why is he here? Why can't he move? He notices the glare Twilight is giving him, along with Rainbow Dash and Applejack. However, Rarity, Pinky, and Fluttershy look hesitant.
Come on, girls!
Twilight shouts at them.
We need to use the elements on him again!
Twilight, I don't think that this is right.
Pinky says, looking far less pink than usual, her mane completely straight.
The princess told us that she wanted all of the elements in Town Square when Anan came back, to fix something dire. What else could she have meant?
Twilight asks. Pinky looks away from her. She knows that Anan isn't a bad human, he's lived with her for a long time. She likes to believe that they've gotten to know each other rather well. She can't, she won't believe the princess meant for something like this to happen. Those two are friends, actual friends. Unlike her.
Twilight, Anan doesn't look so good. Maybe you shouldn't hold him so tight.
Fluttershy whispers.
Get ready, girls. We need to use the elements.
She says, either not having heard Fluttershy or was simply ignoring her.
Twilight Sparkle!
A roar pierces the air loud enough to destroy all the clouds that were hanging in the sky. What happens next couldn't be processed by most living creatures. In a split second, the telekinesis holding Anan evaporates. Before his feet even touch the ground, he feels himself pressing against something. Luna's holding him by her side as he tries to get his mind straight after whatever brought on that intense feeling of vertigo. Once his eyes come back to focus, he looks up to see Celestia standing where he was being held.
What just happened?
Luna must say that she's impressed. It seems that her sister had not lost the art of flash teleportation. Even in her eyes, it was nearly impossible to follow. How her sister deconstructed Twilight's spell on a sub-magical level, and she flash-teleported Anan to where she stood while also taking the place that he stood, her sister was always well-versed in the art of anti-magic and teleportation spells. Anan slowly feels his mind come to grips as he looks over Celestia. Something is very different about her right now. She's on fire. Quite literally. Her mane and tail are blazing infernos as if they were made from the sun itself. He had never seen the sight of her before. Pink mane, sure, that was a bit of a surprise, but this, though? For the first time ever, he actually feels an inkling of fear towards her.
Do not worry,
Luna whispers to him.
She is protecting you.
Luna's voice is enough to calm his emotions. She's right, Celestia pulled him out of that situation. He doesn't need to fear her. However, he can feel that she isn't in a good state of mind right now. He needs to do something before things get far out of hand. Celestia finds her eyes locking with her students. She's about to lose it, but something rests on her withers. She whips her head around to see what pony was crazy enough to challenge her. All of her heat dies out as she sees Anan standing there, and the flames of her mane and tail instantly transform back into their usual pastel color. Anan is safe. That's the thought that takes over her mind. She can see that he's rather shaken up, though, but she can feel it's not towards her. His hand trembles on her withers as she notices that he's looking at the elements again. She can feel the heat rising inside of her, but she contains herself. Celestia looks around and notices that her little display gathered a large crowd. She was hoping to have a nice cup of tea before this moment would happen, but things wanted in life are rarely given. She looks back to the elements. They're all frozen in place. Who wouldn't be? They just saw a side of their princess that no pony had seen since the reign of Discord. Celestia brings her gaze back to the elements.
You will apologize to Anan this instant.
Celestia says in a steady but authoritative tone.
Apologize?
Twilight asks, still shaking in fear. She had never seen her teacher look as angry as she is at this moment. Celestia narrows her eyes.
Now.
The elements quickly gave a collective half-assed sorry. Celestia would call them on it, but their punishments would be enough to drive this lesson home. She looks behind her and notices a stage of some sort. Were they planning an announcement after hurting Anan? She feels sickened by those thoughts, but feels that perhaps this is for the best. This is meant to be public and official, so a stage would do nicely.
Follow me,
Celestia says, giving no room for questions. Celestia wraps her wing around Anan as she walks towards the stage, Luna mirroring her on his opposite side. Anan must say that this ended up being a rather interesting turn of events.
Well, I guess it had to happen sooner or later.
Anan tries to joke. Celestia looks down to him in worry.
They didn't hurt you, did they?
He shakes his head.
No, you got there before anything could happen.
Luna nuzzles Anan gently.
I would be wearing their coats if you came to harm.
Luna states in a deadly serious tone.
Creepy.
Anan says, smiling at Luna.
But flattering.
The three of them, along with the elements, walk onto the stage. Celestia pauses briefly as she points a hoof to the front of the stage.
Elements, stand here.
She commands them. They do as they're told, their backs now facing the rapidly growing audience that is collecting before the stage. Celestia, Luna, and Anon walk towards the small curtain that was set up as well, the three of them stopping only a few feet short of touching it. Celestia removes her wing from Anon. She takes another breath to steady her emotions. Anon can see how stressed she is right now, so he does something that he's never done before. He reaches out and runs the palm of his hand over her cheek, a human version of a nuzzle. At least, that's how he sees it. He just hopes that she appreciates the effort.
It'll be fine.
He tries to calm her the same way that she would for him. Celestia feels her heart skip a beat as she feels Anon's hand travel along her jawline and over her cheek. She's not too sure what to think as she tries to reel in her emotions. She wants to stay focused, but what Anon just did was something that she never thought that he would do. Her mind was filled with retribution before, but now she feels more level-headed. She gives him a thankful nod just before she looks to her sister.
Luna, send a message to the others.
Luna's grinning like an idiot at the display between these two. She gives her sister a nod as she lights her horn up briefly to send the special guests a message. Anon just ignores this. He knows that Celestia made some prior arrangements to make this punishment really hit at the hearts of these ponies. He knows of only one of the guests. The others, Celestia refused to tell him of who they were. It doesn't matter. He'll find out soon enough. As soon as Luna has finished sending her message, she gives her sister a nod. Celestia returns the nod before she faces Anon again. She leans in and gives him a quick nuzzle before she pulls back.
It'll all be over soon. Maybe we can have that cup of tea later?
She offers with a smile, and he gives her a nod.
Of course.
Celestia gives him one last nuzzle before she turns away from him, her stone-cold princess mask now upon her face. Celestia takes small, calculated steps towards the elements, each filling them with dread. They aren't entirely sure what's going on, but they can tell that they've fucked up royally. Celestia stops a few feet away from the elements. She looks down at Twilight, her mask holding firm.
Tell me what you were thinking,
she asks in a steady tone. The weight of her tone causes the elements to gulp in unison as they look to Twilight.
You told us what did I tell you?
Celestia takes another step closer to her.
Elements, Town Square, Anon.
Twilight feels her voice dying out. Celestia moves her vision towards Applejack, the mare shaking on her hooves.
What did she tell you?
Celestia asks.
Twilight told us that you sent a message, something about using the elements on Anon.
Celestia can feel the heat rising. She whips her head towards Rainbow. The mare was trying to stay straight-faced, but still shaking slightly in place.
What did you tell her?
Celestia's tone had been steady this entire time. If anything, the lack of fluctuation is making this entire ordeal worse.
Just as you said, bring the elements into the town square when Anon came back, that you had something dire that needs to be fixed.
Celestia looks back to Twilight.
Now tell me, what were you thinking? I thought you meant that we should use the elements against Anon. I thought he did something bad.
She tries to defend. Celestia lets out a snort. Leave it to Twilight to take her words out of context.
The problem that needs to be fixed is not Anon,
Celestia states.
What else could it be?
Twilight asks.
You.
She looks to each element.
All of you. Us?
Twilight reels back as if she were struck.
What have we done? We'll get to that,
Celestia says before she looks out to the crowd. She takes in the large gathering before her. She can see the confused looks that she's gaining. This doesn't surprise her. However, she has a job to do right now, a great wrong that needs to be made right.
Attention, my little ponies!
She had their attention this entire time, yet it was polite to ask for it anyways.
What you ponies are about to witness today is a trial of sorts. The elements of Harmony are charged with many cases of abuse towards the human known as Anon. We will be conducting a small investigation on a case-by-case basis.
The silence is real. Not a single soul is breathing at this moment, so Celestia takes advantage of it and continues.
I play no favorites to any pony. If you commit a crime and you are found guilty, you will be punished.
She looks to the elements again.
You are all guilty of causing harm to Anon.
She can see them about to protest, but a stern glare shuts them up.
I will give you a moment to plead your case to give every pony your side of the story. However, I will be checking your memories, as well as using lie detection magic. I will not allow myself to be lied to, so don't even try.
Luna and Anon just sit back and watch as Celestia takes a few breaths to steady herself. Anon must say that he hopes that this can all be over soon. He just wants to go home and relax with his two friends. Maybe three, depending on how the other answers after all this is said and done. Celestia picks out her first target. She might as well start with the smallest of charges.
Pinky.
Pinky looks up to Celestia, still sad and straight-maned.
Anonis actually fought tooth and nail to assure that you were not to be punished.
Pinky looks over to Anon. She brightens up a single shade of pink as her mane slightly curls.
From his own mouth, he has spoken of your kindness, and for that, I will not punish you. Nevertheless, I would like to know why you struck him with a rock a few days ago.
Pinky looks to Celestia, confused.
I didn't hit him with a rock, did I?
She looks over to Anon as he just looks to her, a certain curiosity behind his mask. Pinky is really good at sensing things, and her pinky sense tells her that the princess is telling the truth. She honestly doesn't remember that.
I don't know.
Pinky hangs her head in shame before she looks up to Anon again.
I'm so sorry if I did, Anon. I don't remember doing it, but I guess I did.
She starts to get water-eyed. She doesn't want to hurt a friend, even if Anon never accepted her as a friend.
Celestia?
Anon speaks up.
Back off.
Celestia does her magic to assure that the mare isn't lying to her. Surprisingly enough, at no point was Pinky lying to her. Even a small scan showed a large gap in her memory at that point in time. She actually doesn't remember doing any of that. Celestia feels herself worry. Perhaps she'll set up a doctor's appointment for Pinky. Loss of memories is not common. Better to be safe than sorry. Celestia looks over to Anon and gives him a nod. She then sidesteps in front of Fluttershy.
Anon also told me how much he would dislike you being punished. While I agree that punishing you does seem rather harsh, I think you will understand why I'm about to do what I plan next.
She looks out to the crowd.
Fluttershy here has a power, something innate. It allows her to control the emotions of anything that she's looking at. It happens at random and is very powerful. It is known as the stare.
All the ponies in town start to whisper. They had never heard about this before, and Celestia looks down to Fluttershy before continuing.
What you have inside of you is dangerous. Just like magic, you need to be taught how to control it. For that reason alone, you'll be coming back to Canterlot with me to be studied and trained. I cannot allow you to harm another creature because you cannot control this power.
Fluttershy looks on the edge of bursting into tears, but Celestia keeps going.
We will make sure that your animals are well taken care of. Not only that, but we will be sending a trainer to condition them. This entire situation happened because one of your pets bit Anon. We cannot allow animals to bite other creatures. If all else fails, we have alternate means of calming them. It also helps keep the breeding population to a minimum.
Now that got Fluttershy crying. She just falls to the ground with her hooves covering her eyes as she cries. She doesn't want to leave her animals. Celestia shows no remorse, seeing as Fluttershy's friends are going to be getting worse. She walks to her next target, Applejack. The mare looks to her with that fear still present, and Celestia actually feels herself smile a bit at this one.
My sister will conduct a few of these punishments.
Celestia looks over her shoulder to Luna.
Luna?
Luna feels a savage grin cross her lips as she looks over to Anon.
I won't take long.
She says with glee. Man, they weren't getting when those punishments were tame. They were practically non-existent, actually. Now to wonder what the others are gonna deal with. Now let's get on to our royal donators. Top donators: Peter Coldhard, J10 Man, Darkseid, Gauntlet, and Only One Thing. Zar630, Strix, Raiden, Narwhals, Black Moonheart, Drake Love Dragon, Pastel Skies, Austin Roland, CrazyColor557, Stu Hex, Will, Omricon Lyrae, Dospo, Delta Omega, Jack Cage, RuneSlithy9852, Madman Stan, Leslie Perkett, Hunter Norman, Stephen Bingham, LineGut12, Sorcerer Constantine, Hudzaza, and many more awesome people. Thank you all so much for watching this video, and live life to the fullest.